Hey everyone, the name is Aussie Flat. In today's video, we will be going over the process that a majority of levels, both officially made by Valve and those created by the modding community, go through to fruition into a finished product. For this video, I'll be creating a test chamber in the Overgrown style seen in the first chapter of Portal 2. This entire process will be documented throughout the course of this video, so I implore you stick around, you're going to learn a lot. So let's start from the very beginning. Initially, a lot of Valve's puzzles were drawn on paper as a way to prototype them before they'd be created in the Hammerworld Editor, the tool for creating levels in the Source Engine. However, we enjoy a luxury in that Portal 2 comes pre-packaged with level editor inside. This is useful for modders. This replaces that piece of paper step of creating a puzzle. Now, instead of a 2D image that we can't test, we get a fully 3D level editor that allows us to experiment with a puzzle in real time. So to begin, you usually should have an idea in mind of what you want to do. For instance, my puzzle I want to use an excursion funnel. This is a pretty fun element to work with as it basically lets you levitate across the chamber, in its beam of course. So, I'm going to be spending some time to try and figure out what I want to do with this. There's a lot of experimentation you can do with this funnel as it interacts with a lot of elements. It can carry gel, it can carry cubes, you can launch, it can help catch you from a faith plate, you can drop into it from a light bridge. There's a lot of interesting interactions that happen with this element, which is why I'm going to be using it for this. I'll catch back up with you guys in a bit once I figure out a puzzle. And just like that, we have our puzzle fully complete. For most people, this is just where the story ends. They upload the map to the Steam Workshop and they're happy with it. They just go about with their day. But that's not what we're gonna do. What we're gonna do is detail this puzzle in Hammer. In order to do that, we need to make sure what we see in the puzzle is what we're gonna be replicating. We can't directly export this to Hammer. Well, you can, but it's not advised. So we're going to be taking a reference of this puzzle through pictures, and then we're going to be using that to replicate the puzzle in Hammer. Yeah, it looks like shit, I know it does. But that's the thing, all maps always start like this. They always start with its very basic template of how they're gonna look like, because at least then the person making them is gonna know what to do. The next parts will be pretty boring, so I'm gonna be skipping over them. Trust me, you're not gonna be missing out on much. You're gonna be missing out on seeing me setting up all the logic in this map to function. But here we are now, a few hours later, and the level looks basically ready. I've been struggling for a while to figure out how I'm going to make this section work, so you know what, I've decided I'm going to let you guys watch a time lapse of me detailing this map. I'll pop in occasionally. Enjoy the music. We'll be right back. now, we're just about done with the map, so with some final adjustments and tweaks done, let's see how the map looks. And that wraps up the video. Thank you guys for watching. The map is available for download in the description below.